Hey everybody, welcome to That's Football. I'm joined by Ben Foster. It's that time again. It's win, lose or draw. He's got a smile on his face. He's been waiting 2 weeks though because of the international break. We will be predicting the weekend's fixtures because the football's back and the international break is over.
The international break!
But we have to revisit rollover week.
We have to revisit it.
We have to revisit it.
Double bubble this.
You're feeling confident.
I am feeling confident.
Actually, that reminds me. 20 quid.
Have you got 20 quid, yeah?
There we go. This is what's on the table.
Leave it there for a sec.
Ben's very confident. Okay, so, reminder. Win, lose or draw, we predict, and whoever gets it right gets a point for each fixture. We'll take you back to this week that we're talking about. It was game week 4. It was Luton against West Ham. We both went with a win.
No brainer.
1-1. This is where it gets good for Ben. Sheffield United against Everton was the lunchtime kickoff. I said a draw. No, I said an Everton win.
Yes.
You said a draw.
Yes.
2-1 to Ben.
Jordan Pickford helped me out there with that worldy last-minute double.
Brentford-Bournemouth both went for a win. Ended up being a draw.
Yeah.
Burnley Spurs both went for Spurs win. 3-2 to Ben.
Spurs are impressive, by the way. Spurs are really impressive, you know. They're going to be up there and thereabouts this year.
Sheffield United this weekend. They are looking good. City Fulham. Bit close. Well,
no,
it wasn't close, actually.
5-2.
Yeah, 5-2. So 3-4 to you.
Yep.
Chelsea Forest. We both got this one wrong.
Everybody in the world got it wrong.
Chelsea home went.
Yeah, I would go with that.
It was an absolute coupon buster. The bookies must have been rubbing their hands.
3-4, we both got it wrong.
Yep.
Brighton Newcastle, you said a draw.
Yeah.
I said a Brighton win.
I know.
4-4.
I've watched this video back, right? So I've watched this video back and I actually say, oh, I like them both. It's got a draw written all over it. I'm edging on a Brighton win, but I'm going to go draw. But I'm edging towards a Brighton win as well. I'm going to go a draw.
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
4-4, I'm back in it. Palace against Wolves. Both went with Palace. A Palace win.
Yep.
5-5.
Yarrow.
High scores now.
This
High
is
scores.
The one that ruined you. Well, there's two now that are about to ruin you.
All right. Liverpool against Villa.
What are you thinking?
I went with a draw.
What are you thinking?
And he went with a win. You stuttered a little bit. You went, oh, it's close.
Yeah, I
it's
was close. Playing the game.
I'm going to go with a home win.
I was
but when I watched it back, I was like, he's trying to goad
was,
me into
I was lulling you. I was lulling you into go for a draw and it worked. And I went for the Liverpool win and Liverpool popped him.
Villa are like my gran. They don't travel. I don't know what's going on with Villa. I still think Villa are a good side,
yep.
But they got absolutely pumped.
Yeah, they did, yeah.
6-5 to Ben, which gives him the highest score we've had so far. 6 out of 8 into the last game of the weekend. Obviously, Arsenal-Manchester United should have been a draw.
Gatton! Garnacho! Oh, get out! Cook a cat!
And we would have been 6-all, but we're not. We're actually 7-5 to Ben because Arsenal won, and that's what you went with. So you've got the 20 quid.
I went with an Arsenal win, and it was nothing more than pure luck, really. It was nothing more than pure luck. And watching the game, it could have got that. Even that game could have gone anywhere, couldn't it? Really. So yeah. 7 out of 9.
That's
this
a good week.
Week.
That's a good week.
7 out of 9 is incredible. If you put 7 out of 9 right in your accumulator, and you do 2 or 3 different accumulators out there, you're going to win 1 or 2 of them. So 20 quid, thank you. Double bubble this week. I will take that quite happily. Thank you.
Okay. I'll have that back in a minute.
Okay.
Anyway, let's go. We are now on to Saturday's fixtures, another Premier League weekend. I think overall, I'm still beating you by 2.
Yeah.
You know.
Oh, aggregate score.
Aggregate
score.
Because we'll look at that as well.
Yeah.
Right back into it. Wolves against Liverpool is a 12:30 televised game as the Premier League returns. You can start as you won anyway, and you're the guest. What are you going to go with? Wolves against Liverpool. Liverpool, very impressive. Wolves are an odd team.
Wolves are an odd team. Goals. Liverpool, I think, are finally finding their groove. They are winning games now, and I cannot see anything other than a Liverpool away win now.
Yeah, I can't afford to be silly. That's not where I'm going to take my risks.
Yeah.
There is a risk game here, but it's not that. I'm going to go Liverpool win. Right, I'll go first on this one. Aston Villa, 3 o'clock against Crystal Palace. Crystal Palace are a decent side. Villa are unpredictable, but for me, I think Villa at home, it will be the kick up the arse again after the Newcastle game that they had before. I'll go with a Villa home win.
I'm going to go for a draw.
Oh,
I'm going to go for a draw. I think Palace are better than what a lot of people think. Full stop. Home or away, I think they're better than what people think. So a draw.
There we go. Could be a differential there. Fulham against Luton at 3 o'clock. That's back to you. Easy, this.
Easy. It's a Fulham win. It's a Fulham home win. It's...
Are Luton going to get a point all season?
They're going to get a point. They're going to get a few wins.
Will they get double figures?
Yes.
I think they should do, shouldn't they?
They should do.
They are.
You're going for a Fulham win?
Well, the only positive I'd say about Luton is the goal they scored against West Ham is how they're going to stay up.
Yeah.
You know, horrible. Literally, yeah. Keep the ball in the air from your own half, head tennis and score. But yeah, Fulham will win that comfortably. I thought Fulham were good against Man City before the break. Yeah. They just lost their head with that silly offside decision.
It was a silly, we'll talk about it later.
Man United, Brighton at 3 o'clock. One, why is it a 3 o'clock game? Because this is going to be very, very good. And two, is it me first on
me,
this one?
It's me, I think it's me.
No,
is
it's
me?
Not, it's me, it's
oh,
me.
Thank Ooh. Gosh for that.
Man United, Brighton. Look, Brighton are very good. Evan Ferguson, the new Alan Shearer. He's Irish. I'm not being anti-Irish. I love the Irish. I lived there for 3 years, but I can't really say he's the new Tony Cascarino. So, I'm bigging him up saying he's the new Alan Shearer, but I know he's Irish. I'm going to go with a Man United win because they weren't terrible against Arsenal and they're going to have to bounce back. And I don't think Brighton travel as well against the top six, really. Could be a draw, but I'm going to be positive and say United have got to win that 6 points from 12.
I'm going to go absolute rogue again here. I'm going to go Brighton win. I think Brighton...
Possible.
I think Brighton at Old Trafford on that big old pitch will be able to play their style of football to a T. And I think they've found a groove, a real nice groove now as well. So Brighton away win.
Obviously, this depends on the centre-back situation because if Lindelof and... Varane and Martinez are out and it's Johnny Evans and Maguire, Brighton will win this by about 10.
Are you not happy with Johnny Evans and Maguire?
No, fuck.
If you're not, is there any clip we could watch where you might be saying anything about them from last weekend?
I chose to keep myself to myself on that
UK, one. Okay.
They're about as useful as a handbrake on a tortoise. Okay, Spurs, Sheffield United. This is over to you, Ben. It's your club.
Spurs all day long. Spurs are they're going to be a problem this year, you know. They're no longer Spursy, by the way. I think they've passed it over to Chelsea. Chelsea is Spursy now.
They're purring, as you would say.
Exactly.
Interestingly, after this game week, they've got, I think, Arsenal and Liverpool. That's going to be where we really see what Spurs are about. Yep. But they'll beat Sheffield United. As we know, Sheffield United aren't very good. I get a lot of stick from Blades, but, I can only say what I think. And I don't think you're very good. West Ham, that's not where Sheffield United are going to stay up.
Nope.
West Ham against Man City. There's some cracking 3 o'clock games, Ben. I can't speak.
Put this on the pub on Saturday night and you're getting people in there watching this.
3 o'clocks, you've got Villa Palace, you've got Man United Brighton, you've got Tottenham Sheffield United, you've got West Ham
Man City.
What's
the night game?
Newcastle Brentford.
It's a waste of a Saturday night game.
They've got that wrong. So West Ham, Man City's me. Oh, I'd love West Ham to get something, but I can't go against Man City. I'm going to go Man City win. I'd love West Ham to do it, but Man City are going to win this title by Christmas.
Yeah, I totally agree. Man City away win. West Ham very good, but Man City, it doesn't matter who they play, home, away, it doesn't matter. I still back them to win.
Do you think Man City will have it won by Christmas?
No, not mathematically, but they will be 10 points ahead at Christmas.
Yeah, which is basically won it.
Yeah.
5:30 game, you've hinted at it. It's Newcastle against Brentford. Not a good start for Newcastle. 3 losses in a row. Brentford, though, this season, 2 draws at home against Bournemouth, and I think it was Palace. They're not quite right either. This should be bounce back for Newcastle, or is it? Is it a potential? Definitely Brentford could go and get something there.
If it was at Brentford, I would say yes. This is a good game, actually. It's a tough game. It's not the one that I want to see on
Saturday
night
TV.
I will be watching it because I'll probably be in the pub watching it.
It's got nothing else to do.
I'm going to go Newcastle. I'm going to go Newcastle win. I am, just because at home, and it's going to be a must win for them.
I need to do well this week, so I can't afford to go with any gambles. So I will go Newcastle. They're very good at home. St James's Park against Brentford.
Yep.
They need to bounce back. There's a lot of teams that need to be bouncing back this weekend. Into the Sunday games, this is tough to call. 2 o'clock, Bournemouth against Chelsea. I think I'm first on this one. Oh, you know what? I think this is where Lampard actually went and won last season.
His only game.
Yeah, his only game. So that makes me think, will Chelsea have too much for Bournemouth? They've just lost at home to Nottingham Forest. It's so hard to go with a Chelsea win. I think I'm going to have to go, stupidly, I'm going to go with a Chelsea win, but I think
no,
they're so dangerous.
Go for a draw.
I nearly went for a draw.
I'm going to go for a Chelsea win.
Putting a lot of faith in Chelsea.
Listen, don't get me wrong. Forest won 1-0. Chelsea battered them. I mean battered them. They were missing. And the goalie didn't
even
have...
Only
two shots on target. The goalie didn't have many saves to make, but they were so wasteful in front of goal. I'm talking own goals. I'm talking like at the angles, you've just got to hit the target and they miss completely everything.
You see that Jackson miss?
Yeah, one over the bar. Really, really bad.
That Jackson miss was bad, wasn't it?
Considering the week earlier, Pochettino.
He's a man who's got to look in the mirror.
It's good. I like it. Anyway.
We're both going with a Chelsea win.
I'm going to go Chelsea.
Did you put Sterling in your team?
Yeah.
They let you down.
I put Madison in as well, though. Madison went and got me some points.
I wish I'd put Son in. Yeah. 4:30, Everton against Arsenal. I don't know why this is a 4:30 game. I really don't. I don't know. It's you first.
It's an Arsenal win.
Yeah.
It's an Arsenal win. Yeah. Everton could make it awfully awkward for them, and they will do, and it'll be I'm talking a 1-0 Arsenal win or something, but it will be an awkward game for them.
Yeah, I'm going to go with an Arsenal win. And I'll tell you what, this is how bad it is for Everton now. I look at that game and I'm almost putting you in the same category as Sheffield United Arsenal. It's like, you know, I think it's such... Like you say, they could get a result, but to do it, it's going to have to be dogged.
Yeah, well, I think Everton aren't that bad of a team. I don't, but I just think confidence and morale is so low. And that's the way it goes sometimes.
They shouldn't be down there.
When their chips are down, everything seems to go against you. Everybody's head's dropped and it's just hard to get points. It really is. And the last game you want to be playing on a Sunday afternoon is at home to Arsenal.
It's such a shame. I mean, I think as a United fan, you think about Goodison. I always love Goodison. It's the last few months of Goodison before they move. And it was always a game I liked. And if you like an away ground, it's because it's tough.
Yeah, really tough.
And you know, Goodison Park, that crowd, you're always like, whoever's going there, they could drop points. Yeah. And that's the thing they've lost. You look at it now and you go, that's 3 points.
Man United back in the day. Man United, I remember when we used to play against the Everton, away at Everton, you knew for a fact Goodison. It was going to be such a tough match. I remember Alex Ferguson used to say to Wayne Rooney all the time, do not get sent off today. Do not get sent off today. Because he'd be so pumped up for it. Do not get sent off today.
And then we've got Monday Night Football again, which is Nottingham Forest against Burnley. Has to be those two because obviously European football kicks in. So Forest at home to Burnley. Burnley have had a bad start. Yeah. I think we both predicted they would stay up okay, but
yeah,
they're not doing too great. And you're first on that one, I think.
It's... Do you know what? I think this, in their world, in Forest's and Burnley's world, right, this is a huge game. Mm-hmm. For the outer world, it's not a six-pointer, but for these two teams, this is a six-pointer. These are the teams where you stay up. If you beat these, the opposition, if you win these games, these are the games that mean you stay up, and this will be a massive, massive nervy affair. And I just think Forest being at home, everybody knows they are very good at home. I think it's a fantastic result from the other week against Chelsea, so I'm going to go for a home win. But I agree with you, it's been a very bad start for Burnley. I expected a bit more from them, to be honest.
Forest have had a great start. Away to United, away to Arsenal, away to Chelsea.
Yeah.
Like, only lost by one goal in two, and then they beat Chelsea.
Yeah.
I'm going to go Monday night, back from international break. Burnley, I'm going to go draw. There we go.
That was
my one I was going to go for.
We've got some good ones today, so... this could go anywhere. This could be a 6 or 7 niller to somebody or something. Do you know what I mean? This will be an interesting one this week. Good game week.
Get in the comments below because remember, you can play as well. Ben got 7 out of 9 last time, which is 7 out of 10. Sorry, there'll be 10 fixtures. So 7 is the high score that losers will go. Well, I got 7 out of 10 one week. I'm obviously winning altogether aggregate
by two. Yeah,
but I've got to get back. Thanks, Ben.
Pleasure.
Get in the comments and play. Speak to you soon.